Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make retro video game music. Now this should be really fun because it's extremely simple to create this type of music. You just have to know what tools you need. So I'll wait a little bit for everyone to file in the live stream. Today we're going, let me write a message here. Today we're going over retro video game music. So welcome back to the Beehive Live. We had to take a break from the last live stream because we were going over plugins and it got a little dry because we went over all the plugins that we really needed. So the other 700 plugins you really don't need, but it's more for experience. So welcome back. We have Florey, we got JLB in the house, we got Jacob in the house, Thomas is in the house, Jordan's in the house. In the hive, I should say, not the house, the hive. Bazaar's in the hive. Damani's in the hive. Luigi, perfect name for today. Luigi is in the hive. Galen is in the hive. Mike's in the hive. Max is in the hive. Eric's in the hive. Don't know how to pronounce your name, I apologize. You're in the hive. Gabe is in the hive. Ethan's in the hive. Sheriff's back in the hive. All right, so welcome back. So today we're going to go over video game music. It's extremely simple. You really have to think really basic. Okay, so the main secret is just using a bit crusher. So let's go to our master track. Let's open up a few options. Let's go to Decimort 2. Now this is the option I would suggest, but there's also a plugin called Fruity Squeeze, which probably nobody knows about. And this is a free plugin right inside of FL Studio you can use. So this one's a little quirky because it might clip the track. So if it clips the track, I apologize for your ears bleeding now. So what we're going to do is just move this knob over time. They use a little bit of foreign language, so I'm not sure what each knob means unless I turn it because I forget off of memory. Let me see here. Let's turn the square eyes. Now, this should lower the sample rate, but let me just check. Let's check if I am. So now you can hear my voice has a little weird like scratch to it, and it's not sampling all my words. I sound like my radio is cutting out. So that's one thing you could do is simply run it through that. And that's free right inside of FL. Now this knob might get crazy. Let me add a limiter now before anything happens. Just in case it starts to clip randomly. Okay, so let's pull this up. Not sure what preserve does. I think you need impact on before you can go to preserve. So impact is more of, this would be the sample rate. Okay, so it even tells you the samples. So my voice sounds like it's missing certain frequencies. That's because it's sampling at a different rate. So wow, my voice sounds like it's transforming. Okay, so that's the knob you want to look for. So you could try that out. That's another option. That's the free option, but I like Decimort more. So let's go to resample. I'm going to pull this down so you can see the resample mode. Oh, it's going to affect my voice. This is not going to work. Let me see something here. Let's move this. All right, let's move all my tracks to, let's do it this way. We're not going to use that many tracks. Let's just route them here. Give me one sec. So let's load up Decimort. This is basically my master chain. I just don't want to affect my vocals. So what you're going to do is lower your resample rate. So you're doing it. I'm getting a lot of requests for XS Tension. I've never heard the guy. I'll have to do some research. I thank you for your suggestions. I really do thank you for your suggestion. Okay. So Decimort, I'm going to lower the sample rate. And that's the secret. Now you can turn up the preamp a little bit, but the other secret is your bit rate. So you can pull that down as well. This gives you more of a fuzzy tone. Now you don't hear it yet because there's no sound running through it. So let's open up some sounds. Let's go to a very simple, let's keep it FL Studio native. Let's do 3X OSC just to show you how simple this is. Turn off oscillators 2 and 3. We're going to start with the sawtooth, which is this tooth here. Again, the secret is running it through the processing. So let's run this through track 3. Now track 3 is routed to track 2. So this is going to get loud, so let me turn this down. So you want to start with a solid idea, something you can loop over and over and over and over again. So let's right click and tap the tempo. So we're at about 145 BPM. Let's right click, let's go to piano roll. And you want to think of the cheesiest melodies you can think of. Also, you want to think of your notes being full out. The reason you're doing this is because you want to think as if you're programming in MIDI. A lot of this stuff sounds very MIDI based. It's not like somebody sat there with a piano and played the music out for video games. It's very MIDI sounding. So it's okay to be quantized. It's actually probably better you did quantization. So we're doing an octave G. Now, I don't like the sample rate, so let me pull it back down a little bit more. And let's lower the bit rate down to 8. Still a weird, like... Okay, so I'm going to repeat this. So this is something you just want to loop. And I guess it's going to get a little too repetitive. And it's, we're going to loop that. Let's hit shift, pull it over. We're looping that basic loop. So you start with a loop. Bunch, is this live? Yes, this is live. Hope this isn't bad, just to be honest still. Yes, this is live. So we're going over retro video game music. Let me turn that down. The only thing I don't like is the actual sawtooth from 3X OSC, but whatever. So let's use native stuff. Let's just say you don't have any plugins. Let's do Fruity Squeeze. And turn down the square rise amount. And the only thing with this is it clips randomly. That's why I don't use it. It just randomly clipped. Not cool. So I'm going to go back to Decimort. And put it on 8-bit resolution. Now too low makes it too robotic. So I go around 22K. So now it's just based on the sawtooth that you pick. Notice me, sensei. What's up, Jake? All right, let's open up 3X OSC. So now we need something to be another melody. So let's do a square wave now. This stuff is very easy. I mean, it's just once. We didn't do anything crazy to the square wave. We're just running it through that the bit crusher. Let's send this to track 3 so it runs through the processing. So square teeth and sawtooth teeth and square waves are very pronounced as far as harmonic content. So they're very bright. You ask what? Because you what? Yes to me. Yeah. So let's do a bass line. So again, long drawn out notes. Let's turn this down. Everything's starting to clash a little bit. So very robotic, very quantized, very note specific. Everything's the same length. And then we're running it through 8-bit. Citrus has some fire sounds for video games. Let's see. What, under which folder, Jordan? Let's right click. Let's see. There's no video game thing, so let's, I mean, maybe under the ARPs. Or I'm going to show you how to build an ARP too in a second. Now these are very, so the chip, let's see. Oh, under chip, okay. Chip, I don't see chip. Chip, what do you mean? Help me out. Chip, what? Where's chip? Somebody help me. Am I going crazy? Oh, chip right here. Okay. The only thing about this is very stereo. So another thing about sound design when it comes to retro games, they didn't have like 5.1 stereo. So you want to think mono. You want to think extremely simple. Mono, one sound wave. Not a bunch of delay. But, you know, it depends on the video game we're talking about. Okay, what's this noise here? Let's, what is this noise? Okay, the feedback was going through. That is pretty cool. Let me show you how to create that. from scratch, just in case you don't know how to do it. So let's open up 3xOSC. Let's turn off oscillators 2 and 3. Let's go to a sawtooth. Let's go to the wrench tool. Here's where we can arpeggiate. So game making, game music. That's pretty funny. Let's go to the arp. Let's go to the wrench tool. Go to the arp tool. Let's go up. We want this arpeggio to go over 4 octaves. That's what range stands for. And we want it to do that quickly. So let's lower our time to something faster. And that's really what it is. That's all it is. You just play nice short notes. Now, of course, you add effects to it, but again, retro video games didn't have a bunch of reverb and stuff on it. It just comes down to the sound source. Let's use a pulse wave instead. So let's add that little arp hit in there. Let's kind of build this up. So I don't want everything in one pattern. Let's have that arp kind of come in over time. And I'm going to show you another trick using white noise, how to make those Pokemon sounds like somebody just mentioned, like a rocket type of sound. Let's go to the playlist. So it's a little too much movement. So you have to think of it like a song. So let's make that unique. Let's take out something. One of these things is moving too much. And I want to say, let's take out the top line melody. So let's take that out. See, now it's not as much conflict. There's too much movement when the melody's gone, the bass line's gone, the arp's gone. Too much movement. So you have to kind of cut stuff out. So I'm going to show you the core fundamentals of video game sound. So we just went through, what is this here? Top line melody. Then you want to contrast it with bass. So the top line melody is, the secret is it's going through an 8-bit plugin like Decimwork 2, or you can use Fruity Squeeze. That's an alternative. Or any bit crusher, okay? We're going to lower the sample rate and ultimately lower the bit rate as well, not just the sample rate. And we have a simple sawtooth for our first melody, our top line melody here. No effects on it, just regular. Next is our bass line, which is a simple pulse wave playing really low octaves. And the notes are very quantized. Okay, so they're very on the grid. They're very specific note lengths. They're very, you know, to the book. Now pattern three goes over our arp creation. Again, if you missed it, it's a simple square wave. Then we're going to go to the wrench tool of 3xOSC, just showing you can do this in any plugin. Go to the wrench tool, hit, go to arpeggio, go to up direction, because you want to make it a happy arp. Usually happy arps go upward. We're going to set our range or our octave range to 4 octaves, and then our time, we're going to set that to something fast. So welcome everyone just joining. We're going over retro video game music and all the fundamentals. The next sound is going to be our vibrato sound. So this one's going to be a little more elegant. Let's go to... Now it can be a sawtooth or a triangle. Let's start with the triangle first because we want it to be a little more subtle. Now the key here is we need legato. So let's go to our wrench tool. Let's turn on monophonic. This means we can only play one note at a time. The slide meter means we can play legato. That's how long it takes from pitch to glide from one note to the next. That's all I want is legato in mono mode. Next, we need to add a vibrato effect. So let's go to our envelope section. Let's go to pitch. We need to set an LFO and a sine wave motion to our pitch. Let's turn up our amount. I just want to exaggerate it first, so you can hear the movement of the pitch. There are even video game sounds like this, in a very exaggerated pitch bending. But we want it a little more subtle. So let's increase our speed. And let's lower the amount. So it's very subtle. And then I'm going to add an attack curvature to it so it doesn't come in right away. They call me game. Okay. So now let's create like a long tail melody once we take out that blip melody. Okay, let's go to here. So now I'm going to make a long melody using mostly legato. So let's zoom in on this section here. So this can be like your little solo. So let me kind of focus in on the solo. Yeah, my real name's Game. You can be as computerized as you want with this genre. That's the best part. And cheesy. You can be very cheesy. I actually want these notes to smack instead of legato. So octave play here. And then I could just repeat that. Let's just repeat it and make small variations so we can keep the live stream going. So now that you know the secret, it's really just about bit crushing and about very, very simple sounds, keeping them mono, keeping them direct sound waves, and also not adding a bunch of reverb and delay. Unless you're going into more modern kind of video games, like arcade video games that are very modern with stereo sound and reverbs and all these type of things. Like if you're playing Yu-Gi-Oh! On Nintendo DS, that's going to have a lot more reverb and those type of things. But if you're going for like a Game Boy game, you want to think mono and you want to think very simple sound waves, because the speakers on the Game Boys weren't the best. So you have to think about it that way. They had very simple speaker systems, so they needed sounds that could translate over that system. They didn't have sub bass systems on the Game Boy. Please don't make it trap. That'd be fun. Let's make a new genre of trap called arcade trap. I think that's worth a video. I think we could trap this up. Let's actually do it this video. Arcade trap. I'm just gonna halftime the drums out of nowhere. And then, what do you think about arcade trap? You think we should push that genre? Who's down for some arcade trap? I think that'd be a fun genre. So that's the melody. You can spend more time on it. I'm just kind of shortening it up. All right, so now let's get into the last fundamental sound, which is white noise. Let's go here, 3XOSC. And let's go to the randomized or noise patch. Arcade trap sounds booming. That's pretty funny. Arcade fire. All right, so let's send this to track 7. Let's turn this down because it's going to be loud. And let's turn off oscillators 2 and 3. So again, the secret is just using very simple oscillators. We're not using anything complicated. But now it's going to get a little more complicated because with white noise, we have to shape it. So that's where it gets complicated. Because by default, it's not going to play a tone. So we have to kind of tell it what to do. So firstly, let's go to the wrench tool and tell Mod X to be key track. So what that means is my filter will move based on the key I play. Let's turn Mod X all the way up. Let's go to our envelope now and set the filter to a bandpass filter and then just set it randomly. So now when I play different frequencies, as I turn up the resonant, you can hear different tones. This is like the AOL when it's dialing up. But we need to make it more tonal, so let's increase the resonance knob. Now I wish the resonance, let's see. Yeah, we can, okay. Let's go to the wrench tool, let's turn up Mod Y. I guess that didn't do much. And we can't really shape this as much as I thought we did. Could, I mean. But this sound, I'm going to run it through a little more bit crushing. So let me open up Decimort on this specific sound. And let's route this to the, never mind, let's not reroute it. I'm going to crank it up with preamp and turn down the output. And I'm also going to run it through a little more bit reduction. Okay, now also we need to add an envelope, so it's an impact. So let's go to envelopes, give it a decay curvature and a little release. Just a tiny bit. Now this is not the sound I'm going for, mainly because it's bandpass. Let's take off the filter. It's just not, the filter's not working the way I wanted it to. So I'm going to have to use the EQ2 instead. It might sound good just as is. But before we go to Decimort, let's go to Parametric EQ2. And I want to make this... How can we do this? How can we do this? I want the filter resonance to move as we do... It might work this way, let's just say. Let's not give up on it yet. So the trick is distorting it and also adding resonance to your noise. Now you're gonna have to spend a lot more time on the resonance. You gotta be careful with that because you can blow out your eardrums. So that was way too long. So let's pull in the release and pull in the decay. Oh yeah, we should make some 8-bit drums. That'd be cool too. You just reminded me. All right, so let's... Okay, so in short, I'm gonna have to kind of speed through this because it goes over a lot of sound design, which we go over at busyworksbeats.com/sounddesign. You can learn a lot more. Let's open up 3X OSC. And again, we wanna route this to our mixer, so it's running through Decimort 2. So we have a simple sine wave. We're gonna go to envelopes, give it a decay curvature. We're gonna tell the kick to go boom. We're just going to play, I'm just going to right click these C's so it lowers the octave. Now, in real life, not in real life, but you know what I mean. In video games, you're not going to hear all that sub bass. So let's see what we can do here. I'm also going to run it through Decimort again and then preamp it to distort it. So that's the trick for your drums. You just want to distort your drums. That's where you get that kind of bass line sound. When did you start making music? About 3 years ago, intensely. But making music, I was always really into making music. So let's create a small pattern here for our drum pattern. Let's make trap drums that sound 8-bit too. I don't know if this is even gonna make sense. I need to tune the kick. It needs to be boom. So we need to pull that down to G. Let's make the kick into like an 808. Let's extend the release time. So I guess we're gonna make an 808 8-bit. An 808, an 8-bit 808. Isn't that something? Now this sound, I don't like how stereo it is. So let's pull that into mono. That's the one reason why that sounded off is because it's stereo. So pull all your stuff to stereo mono. Now this, let's shape it a little bit more. The kick is tuned. You might be a little lag. Let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. Excuse me. There's just too much going on. The one thing about 8-bit is that when you have too much going on, it gets too complicated. So you really have to space out your sounds. So let's make that unique and go. Let's do an 808 slide in 8-bit. Let's see what that sounds like. Are we on the 808? Let's right click, go to piano roll. So I'm gonna go woo woo. Let me see here. So let's go G, D. Now the thing is we need to slide up to G. So let's, excuse me. Let's pull this over. Just one half, one little step. Let's double click and make it a slide note so that we're sliding up to that note. Now we need to give it a root note. So let's make the root note just two octaves lower. You can't even hear it. So let me see. I got to fix the timing here. So I'm going to go whoop, whoop. So this probably looks complicated, but I have a video on 808 slides. If you type in 808 slides, Busy Works Beats, it will pop up on YouTube. Slides are a little loose, but you might have to change your slide time. Oh, we don't have it. Okay, so it's too much going on, in my opinion. Like this, I want to go left and right. But again, we want to keep it mono, which is straight centered, straight one track. If you have emails, our support team will get to it. So, you know, give us a little bit. We'll handle that for you. Let's drop the... Oh, you know what? That's a bass line that's playing up top. I forgot. If you missed the live stream, my apologies, but you can go back and rewind in the live stream to see how we created the 8-bit sound. You don't even need Decimort. You can use Fruity Squeeze. So that's the alternative as far as the free version, I guess. So let's see what we have so far. It's a little flat, the 808. So that vibrato sound is like mimicking a flute, but you know, the video game version. You got bars. They are funny, man. Okay, let's add an arpeggio. I'll show you a quick trick. Let's see here. Where are we at? Pattern 3. Let me show you a really secret trick. If you go to the wrench tool, you can right click on time for your arpeggio, create an automation clip, and what you can do is have your arp speed change over time. So I'm gonna have that do, let me see here, let's paste it here and give it an increased speed. I went backwards, let's do the opposite direction. So that's how you get multiple speeds out of one arp sound without using a different bunch of different arps. So we can use that like every other bar. That'd be something cool. Arp modulation. So we went over that in our automation tutorial some time ago. So type in automation Busy Works Beats if you want to learn more about that specific technique. Let me see here. Okay. Cut off band stop. Okay. Yeah, let's use, instead of leaving all the bass, let's take out some bass. You're right. I did say bass isn't even in a video game. So let's use a high pass filter. Band pass. This 808 does sound like. So it's based on harmonic content, so tuning is very... I don't know about the... Let's see. I don't know why the 808 sounds out of tune all of a sudden. But anyway, so that's how you would do that. If you have too much bass, you add that high pass filter. I'd say that's probably the lowest I'd go. I think that sound had more bass than that. So let's cut it off at about 300, 200 hertz. Yeah, good. She gotta go. See ya. Bye. You don't deserve to be in our presence, Ghost. No, I'm not using Serum. I'm using FL Studio native plugins called 3X OSC. It's okay. If you missed the stream, well, you know, it'll be archived on YouTube, which means you can watch it later. Good night. Where is it night in the world? That's pretty cool. Waveform is the beginning melody. It's a sawtooth. Just a simple sawtooth. Nothing else done to it. We're running it through Decimort, which is lowering the sample rate and the bit rate to 8 bits, and then the sample rate's lowered as well. So of course we had to trap it up, you know, turn a video game into some trap. So maybe arcade trap will be a genre. Maybe not with the drums, but maybe with trap drums and just arcade sounds in the back. That'd be a cool genre to experiment with. Now let me show you one more trick, which is to add release to your sounds. So here's one more trick they use for like strings and things. So let's go to sawtooth, turn off oscillators 2 and 3. Again, very simple sounds. One oscillator, centered, mono. We're not getting too complicated as far as sounds. I tried to make a trap beat as far as like using digital sounds. I didn't use any trap samples. Let's go to the envelope. Let's turn the release tail up and the decay curvature up. Now the thing is we need to filter this because it's a very bright tone. Also, we need to give it a little bit of attack. The only thing I don't like about this is it sounds very harsh. And that's just the nature of the sawtooth that they have. But this is how we get those kind of Mario haunted, like if he's in a dark dungeon somewhere. I'm playing with my QWERTY keyboard. I should probably play with my MIDI, but I don't have it turned on right now. So let's add like a section where it breaks down and gets dark. So let's get rid of the happy arp. And let's add in some dark chords. Chord was that? Start on D minor, DFA. So now our music theory, too much white noise. I agree. That's the nature of 8-bit. Let's do, actually we're in a different scale, I forgot. I should probably map out the scale, but I don't feel like doing it. So C minor. Yeah, the let me see something here. The bit rate is determining the noise level, but a lot of the games are known to be 8-bit, so that's where that noise is coming from. It's definitely not the right chord. I just don't feel like mapping out the scale right now, but... I should probably map out the scale to make this a lot easier musically. Let's just do that. So the scale is... Okay, do 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 do. That's the scale. It does have a lot of white noise. You're right. It's Let's pull that over. Let's turn that down. This is a scale reference. Let's just hold shift, pull it up an octave. So we have two octaves worth of notes. I'm just using that as a reference so I know the proper chord. Decimort is from D16 group. You can Google it. Google it. Google it. Just Google it. Google it. Google it. All right. We're going to have G as our top note. And then we're going to have D sharp. And then we're going to have C. So I was right. I was right. No, wait. No, wait. Something's wrong here. Yeah, C. It just doesn't sound like the right chord. So let's do G is the root. And A sharp and D. Not feeling the chords anymore. Let's just lift these up to the next note in the scale. Let's pull this down to C minor. Not as dark as I thought it'd sound, but so you want to think attack and release. So I'm not going to make this video longer than it needs to be. We already went over the fundamental sounds. Let me just play it all the way through. Now, of course, you would take it and make a longer melody and make it more interesting along the way. I just showed you the bare bones of retro video game music. So let's run this through a couple times. Probably use a hi-hat or something, but I don't want to extend this video way too long. We're gonna wrap this up, this hour up. Yeah, hi-hats would definitely make it better. Oh, you know what I did? I knew something was wrong. I left out a bar of chords. Let's do that one more time. Hi-hats would make this kind of cool. Let's just add a simple hi-hat and then wrap it up. And then at 3 o'clock, we're going to do a different live stream on Facebook, however, not on YouTube. So at 3, we're going to be on Facebook. So let me see. At 3, go to facebook.com/busyworksbeats for the next live stream. And over there, we're going to go through the limited series where we stick to one either set of plugins or one plugin and make a track out of it. Okay, or one approach. So let's go back to the beginning. Thank you. didn't make a full song. I'm just showing you the core fundamentals of video game music. We're not sitting here writing out a full composition. I mean, you could spend way more time on it. I don't want to waste your time. We went over core fundamentals. We went over Sawteeth, how to process it using, and goodbye, Kid Nova. I guess you just want to die today. Bye. 3X OSC. We're running it through an 8-bit crusher. So that's what it is, through Decimort. We're lowering the sample rate as well as lowering the bit rate. So it gives you that crushed, noisy sound. So we're very basic sound waves. Sawteeth, pulse wave for the bass lines. And we got a little more complicated when it came to the arpeggio. So we go an arpeggio, 4 octaves. You can vary the speed if you want, just a simple pulse wave, nothing done to it. Remember to keep your sounds in mono. Now the vibrato was a little more, you know, steps involved. You can rewind the video to learn that about that. But it comes down to adding a vibrato. And again, one sound wave, which is a triangle. Then the noise was a little more complicated. We had to do some processing to it. Okay. And then the sub bass was just a simple sine wave distorted through Decimort or any bit crusher. The pads were just a simple sawtooth with an attack and release. Run through that bit crusher. And lastly, I don't think we used that one. So that is going to wrap this live stream up. We're going to move into the next live stream, which is our limited series where we use only one plugin to produce stuff. Okay, whether that's a mixing plugin or a plugin for a composition. So I appreciate you joining today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.